All right, guys, we're doing it. We've done a few before, but today we're doing it. Welcome to CoinMarketCap Tuesday tutorials, where we make it easy for you to get the most of all the crypto tools out there. My name is Trev, and today I'll be showing you some of the hidden features and also how to get the most out of CoinMarketCap.com. Some of the things in the video that I'll be going over is the general overview of CoinMarketCap.com, watch lists, what they are and how to customize them, the followers feature, how to follow other accounts and watch lists to see what other coins they're looking at, and also a brief overview of the mobile app. So let's get started. But first, if you're interested in us making more of these videos, hit the like button down below so we know to make more. All right, so let's start off with a quick overview of the new updated homepage on CoinMarketCap.com. Starting here at the top, you can see the amount of cryptocurrencies that are being tracked on the website, which right now is 11,444. Moving along, we have the amount of exchanges that are being tracked, ranked by review, etc. Then moving across, we have the market cap currently at around $2 trillion. And then we have the 24-hour volume at 106 billion. Next up, we can see the dominance over the market with Bitcoin at 43.8% and Ethereum following at 18.2%. And right next to that, we have the ETH gas fee. Moving along here at the top, you can also select whichever currency you want to view your tokens or coins in, and then right next to that we can also toggle on the dark theme. Coming down here, you can also click on the CoinMarketCap logo, and what that's going to do is it's going to bring you to the home page. So if you go to any other page and you simply click on this logo, you will be brought back to the home page. Next up, we have the cryptocurrencies. You can see them by ranking, which is the current screen that we are on right now. Then you can also see the recently added coins or tokens. Then you can see even a new feature which was just recently added, which is the price estimates. Then you can see the countries which have added anything as a legal tender. Then you can see the global charts, fiats and companies ranking. You can see the spotlight, gainers and losers, and also a historical snapshot. So if you wanted to see the price point at any given point of time, you can also click on that. It's quite an interesting feature. Next up, we have the exchanges. You can look at the spot, derivatives, or decentralized exchanges, and also where to buy. So for example, if we wanted to go over the spot exchanges, it's a pretty cool feature because it shows the exchanges ranked by their score on here. So you can see the top 10 in here, and you can also scroll down and look at any other exchange and what their score is ranked on. And then going back up here, if we wanted to go back to the homepage, we could simply hover over CoinMarketCap and click on that, and we'll be brought right back. Moving along with exchanges, we also have NFT, so you can see the various different NFT collections, and you can look at their total volume and also the amount of assets that they have. Quite an interesting feature. Right now, we're going to skip over portfolio and watch list because we're going to dive deeper into them. So make sure to watch until the end of the video for them. Over here, we have calendars. You can see the different airdrops, initial coin offering calendar. So if we wanted to click on that, and then we could see here which coins are going to be listed soon, their up and coming projects, ongoing projects, etc. We can see all of that here. Moving along over to products, you can see the converter, which will essentially show you how much of what currency will equal to another currency. Or we can go over and you can see the mobile app, which we're also going to be talking about pretty soon. And also you can see the different blockchain explorer, the interest, you can see how much interest you can earn on a specific coin. Or also if you want a job, you can check out the jobs board and try to get a job into the cryptocurrency industry. Moving along, we have Learn, and over here you can see Alexandria. This will bring you up to the Alexandria page, and this is also something that we talk about quite a lot, where you can ask Alexandria anything you want about a specific term or methodology in cryptocurrency, and you can do that over here. This is essentially what it is. It's a great place to learn about cryptocurrencies, learn how-to guides, learn the blog, the different glossary and words and terminology that are used amongst the community. Next up, we have the earn feature, where you can go over and learn about a different token or coin, and then you can even be rewarded in the crypto that you learned about. Quite an interesting feature. Highly recommend to check that one out. And moving along, you can go over to the search bar. You can see what is trending right now, what people are looking up, and then you can also see your recent searches. So once you log in and click on watch list, you're going to find that your watch list is obviously empty. So how to add coins is extremely simple. All you have to do is either go down here to add a coin, and you can simply look up any coin that you wanted to, and then select that coin, and then boom, add it to your watch list. Or you can go back over to the homepage and find any other coin that's either ranked by market cap or simply search it up and find it. And then all you have to do is click this star button right next to that coin and it will be added to your main watch list. And if you accidentally hit that and you didn't want that coin there for whatever reason, you could also hit this star here and it will remove it from your main watch list. So after you add a few coins or tokens to your watch list, then you can go head right back over to watch list and you're gonna see where it says my first watch list. You can go over this and also change this name at any point in time. I'm going to name this one watchlist for September. Over here, you can also make it public. You can also share this link with anyone else if they wanted to access it too. You can also add a quick description if you wanted to. And over here, if you wanted to create another watchlist, you can just go over to this, create that watchlist. So let's just say you wanted to have one for October. You can simply do that right here. So now I have watchlist for October, simply create it. And then you can simply add coins to it whenever you wanted to. Moving back to my previous watch list, you can also sort this by whatever you wanted to. So for example, price, the 24 hour change percent, the 7 day change percent, and the market cap, volume, and circulating supply. And of course, if you wanted to share it at any point in time, you could go over here, share it, make it public, and then just copy the link, send it over to your friends, or maybe you make YouTube videos about cryptocurrency, you could just list that in the description below. So let's go over to the popular feature. Here you can see different popular watch lists ranked by their followers. If you wanted to follow one, just go over here to where it says follow and just click on those. Then if you wanted to see at any point in time the ones that you are following, you would just go back over here to where it says following. If we wanted to open up one of these, we could simply see what they're following, what they're talking about, and maybe do more research about one of these coins. Going back to the home screen, if you wanted to also look at your portfolio, you can simply do that here. So how does it work? Over here, you can see my main portfolio. If you wanted to change this name, simply go over to where it says more, edit portfolio, and then we can change that at any point. So for the sake of this example, I'm just going to name it Exchange 1. Let's just say you wanted to name it as your current exchange that you bought or sold that asset on. So if we wanted to look at and add our transactions of whatever coin that was, for example, Bitcoin, and you bought at a quantity of 0.05, $2,370.56 at the current date and time. And also if you wanted to add a fee of whatever it was, maybe the exchange charged you a fee or there was a fee to purchase that. And then you wanted to add a note here of something else, maybe more specific. You can also do that there. And we can add this as a buy transaction, boom. Done. So once that's tracked, now you will be able to see your current balance. You can also hide that number if you wanted to, and you'll be able to see it given over a period of time. And also at any point in time, you can go over here, and if you wanted to, say, for example, sell a specific asset at a specific price, you can do that here, and it's going to track all of the different numbers. It's going to track everything for you, and it'll even tell you down here how much profit loss you've had, the average buy price, etc. There's a bunch of different features to use amongst that. Going back to the homepage, if we wanted to look at any other coin, for example, Cardano, you can see some of the different stats on here. You can see the contracts, you can see their website, you can see the community, the different social media platforms that they are on. You can also check out the source code, white papers, etc. You can also see the rank and how many other people have it on their watch list. And of course, the price, the high and the low within the past 24 hours. You can check out in the past year, the high and the low. And moving down here, you can see some of the different tokenomics when it comes to that specific coin. You can also look at it in a converter view. You can see the different charts. And for example, if you wanted to look at a candle chart, you could come down here, click on trading view, and it'll show you the trading view of that chart. Come down here and then you would just select the candle option. It's a really awesome feature because it enables the trading view option and feature within and amongst CoinMarketCap.com. So over here, you could look at your various different indicators, zoom in, zoom out, and compare it to other different coins, for example, Bitcoin. Moving on down, you can see the live price data. You can also check out here if you wanted to look at what is Cardano. And then moving on down, you could even see the different price estimates on people in the community that have voted on whichever price they think it is. And then also you can vote on how you think Cardano is doing today. So for example, if you wanted to click good, you would then be able to see that however much the community also thinks that it's good or bad. So next up, I wanted to briefly go over what it's like on the mobile platform. So here we are on the main home screen. We can see the price alerts. We can see if you wanted to compare various different currencies, and then also convert as well down here, and also the watch list, and of course the top coins of the day and gains and losers of that day as well. And then also on the news. Now, going back up here, if we wanted to look at our watch list, here you can see what I've added from before, and this is what I just did on my computer. They're all right in there. So those are that's the watch list for September that I created. And then moving right along, we can see the ones that I'm following and also the popular ones out there. Going back to the home screen, you can go over here to where it says price alerts, click on that. And if you wanted to see any coin or projects, for example, Bitcoin, and you wanted to see it at, for example, I don't know, if you wanted to look at it when it's at $50,000, you wanted to be alerted when it hits $50,000, set that alert price there, and you will be notified when that coin goes right above $50,000. Quite a cool and interesting feature, and you can add as many as you want. Going down here, you can just see some of the assets ranked by market cap. Moving right along, we have the portfolio view. So this was that input that I put in earlier of the Bitcoin at that buy price. So here you'll be able to see the line chart once it's obviously updated in the up and coming days of whenever you bought that currency, and you'll be able to see it over time go up or down. Moving right along, we have the pie chart view, so you can see at which of your holdings do you have of what, and it's kind of just a nice feature to see that. Then we also have some of the statistics, so you can see there's also a loss already at $13.71. And also with this I button in the top right, you can access the privacy mode. So if you're not comfortable with sharing the amount of money that you have in that holding, for example, then you can just go to that and it will hide that, and it's just going to show your percentages. Then moving right along at the bottom here, we can see the discover page where we can look at some of the trending news articles, and also just going down, you can see the specific news articles for that specific coin or feature or project. And then going over here to the bottom right, we can click on some of the different setting features that we can have for our account. For example, if you wanted to switch it to dark mode, you can also do that here. If you wanted to turn on the biometric authentication feature, like a fingerprint when you log into the app, you can also do that right here. And then you can also select it to where once you open the app, you can change whichever page you want to look at first. Anyways, guys, we thank you for tuning in to this episode of CoinMarketCap's Tuesday Tutorials, where we make it easy for you to get the most out of all of the different crypto tools out there. And now I pass the challenge on to you, dear subscribers. It's in your hands to get more people to understand crypto and all of its potential. Make sure to share this video with a friend, and if you have any questions, just ask Alex in the description below. Bye for now.